This video shows you how sites and locations are used in BMC Remedy ITSM and related applications, and provides some basic information about how they are configured. After watching, you should be able to determine which locations to create for your environment and what information to gather before creating them. Locations are part of your foundation data and represent a company's physical geographical locations, such as offices, campuses, or warehouses. The relationship of a company to a site identifies a unique location, but a site can be related to more than one company, which is a likely scenario if you're using companies in ITSM to represent business units within your organization. The location hierarchy can optionally include a region, a site group, or both if you need those layers to organize your sites. In menus throughout ITSM and related applications, the company that you select restricts which regions are displayed, if any, the region that you select restricts which site groups are displayed, if any, and the site group that you select restricts which sites are displayed. Though they all use the same top-level companies, this location structure is different from the support group and business organization structures, which are described in separate videos. A location in ITSM represents a physical location with a mailing address. In several types of requests and in software CIs, you must specify at least the company level of a location. Also, when performing searches or other workflow against locations, you can do so at any level of the structure. Next, you'll see how locations are used across ITSM, BMC Service Request Management, or SRM, and BMC Service Level Management, or SLM, starting with those uses that are common to several applications. Locations can be specified for requests, such as this incident, problems, known errors, changes, releases, and service requests, and other objects such as configuration items, people, broadcasts, change activities, business events, operational categorizations, solution database entries, and service level agreement contracts. When you specify a location, you can provide just the company, the entire hierarchy, or either level in between. In requests that have an assignee, a request's location can be one of the factors considered in automatic assignment. For example, this record automatically assigns incidents occurring at CalBro's headquarters site to their service desk group. You can specify the location of a CI to a finer level of detail than the site. A company is necessary for software CIs to enable software license management, and for software that is subject to site licenses, you must also specify a site. Bulk inventory CIs don't have location fields themselves. Instead, they can be related to inventory location CIs. In a multi-tenant environment, location controls access to requests and CIs. Only users who are members of the location company of a record can view or modify the record. This does not apply to broadcasts, which are visible to all users. Location also controls display in the consoles of ITSM applications. When you select a company in a console, only records whose location company matches that company appear. The location specified for an incident, problem, or change request, or for a CI, represents the physical location of the CI affected by the record. But you can specify additional locations that are affected by the record. Each impacted area you relate to a record contains a location structure. The Change and Release Management application uses locations in several additional ways. You can specify a location for either a business event or an operational categorization so that when you register a time segment against either object, the time segment applies only at the specified location. For example, this Thanksgiving holiday shutdown applies only to the United States. When using the Schedule Assist tool to schedule a change or release request, location is one of the criteria used to match the request against these time segments. The tool would not match the Thanksgiving shutdown against a change request for a computer in Amsterdam, even if searching the date range that contains that event. You can also use location to filter release requests in the change calendar. This helps you narrow potential conflicts to those that actually affect the change or release that you're planning. In SLM, you can use locations in the qualification that matches a service target with incidents, changes, releases, and service requests. For example, this service target will be attached only to incident requests from CalBro Services. Before looking at configuring location structures, let's review the ways that they're used in ITSM, SLM, and SRM. You can specify a location for various ITSM requests, SRM service requests, CIs, people, and several other types of objects in ITSM and SLM. The location of a request can help determine its automatic assignment to a support group or person. The location of a software CI can help attach it to a software license certificate. The location company of a request or CI determines who has access to it in a multi-tenant environment. Additional locations can be related to a request or CI to show other areas that it impacts. Location can filter the records displayed in ITSM consoles and in the change calendar. You can apply a location to a business event or operational categorization for more accurate scheduling of changes and releases with the Schedule Assist tool. And you can include a location in the criteria that match requests to a service target. To configure your locations, work from the top down. If you haven't yet created companies as part of your business organizations, which is described in a separate video, create them now. From the standard configuration tab on the Application Administration console, click here to create and configure a new company. When your companies exist, return to the standard configuration tab on the Application Administration console. Select a company for which to create locations, and then next to location, click create. You can create sites for the company, and if you need extra organizational layers, also create regions, site groups, or both. With your locations created, you can now select them from menus in ITSM, SRM, and SLM when editing a record. But sometimes you might need to set the location for a large number of records, such as when your discovery tool doesn't populate the location fields. This prevents your software CIs from attaching to license certificates. Using the Manage Bulk Updates feature of the Asset Configuration Management application, you can perform bulk updates to set the location of multiple CIs at once. When planning your location structures, consider these points. What are your reporting needs? What criteria will you use to automatically assign requests? What criteria will you use to map service targets to incidents, changes, and other requests? Begin by determining your sites. Then decide whether you need regions and site groups to organize them. Site names must be unique, so if more than one company has a site by the same name, be sure to include all or part of the company name in the site name when creating those sites in ITSM. We hope this video has helped you understand how location structures are used in BMC Remedy ITSM and related applications, and some basic information about how they are configured. Thank you for watching.